Welcome to Fix Me Master. Are you running into problems activating a Python virtual environment in PowerShell while using Visual Studio Code? In this quick tutorial, we will walk through common issues and their fixes, step by step. Perfect for beginners looking to get their Python setup running smoothly. Let us dive in. Step 1, check if your virtual environment folder exists. In Visual Studio Code, open a terminal by going to the Terminal menu and selecting New Terminal. Create the virtual environment by typing python-m venv venv and pressing Enter. Wait for the command to finish, then check again for the venv folder. Step 2, activate the virtual environment correctly in PowerShell. In the terminal, type scripts activate and press Enter. Make sure to include the dot and backslash at the start. This tells PowerShell to run the script from the current directory. If it works, you will see vnviv appear before the terminal prompt, confirming the environment is active. Step 3, fix execution policy restrictions. If you get an error about scripts being disabled, it is likely due to PowerShell's execution policy. To fix this, type set-execution-policy-unrestricted-space-scope-process and press Enter. This allows scripts to run for your current session. You might need to run PowerShell as an administrator, so close Visual Studio Code, right-click the PowerShell application, select Run as Administrator, then reopen Visual Studio Code and try activating again. Step 4, test the activation. Step 4, verify the virtual environment is active. In the terminal, type python --version and press Enter. It should show the Python version tied to your virtual environment. You can also type pip list to see the packages installed in the environment, which should be minimal, like pip and setup tools. If everything looks good, your virtual environment is ready for coding in Visual Studio Code. And there you go. You have fixed the common issues with activating a Python virtual environment in PowerShell for Visual Studio Code. Now you're set to code without interruptions. If this helped, give us a thumbs up, share with a friend, and subscribe to Fix Me Master for more tech tips. Drop a comment if you hit any other snags, and we will see you in the next tutorial.